Reforestation is exactly what it sounds like, replacing forests that have been cut down or restocking forests that have been degraded through human activities like logging or natural means like forest fires. Experts say that we have a lot of need for reforestation. Researchers estimate that the world lost as much as 411 million hectares of tree cover, or more than 1 billion acres, between 2000 and 2020, an area larger than India. Much of it fell to make room for agriculture, and deforestation is continuing at an alarming pace. Yet, forests are considered one of the best ways to fight climate change, and they offer a host of other benefits to both people and the planet. Around the world, people are planting trees, often on a massive scale. So what does it take to regrow a forest? Most of the time, reforestation consists of planting trees. But it would be extremely difficult and costly to actually plant the same number of trees and the same number of tree species that exist in native forests. So reforestation practitioners often take additional measures to encourage forests to regrow. The most important of these is protecting the land from further disturbance. In fact, allowing forests to regrow naturally is an integral part of reforestation, because even tree planting can't reproduce a native forest in all of its biodiversity. So, to some extent, all reforestation initiatives rely on nature's ability to naturally regenerate forests. Plus, it's more cost-effective to simply let a forest regrow than it is to harvest and store seeds, grow and plant seedlings, and then care for the newly planted trees to ensure they survive. Natural regeneration can work well when there are healthy forests nearby to supply seeds. But since many forests have been cleared altogether or have become severely degraded, tree planting is often necessary. Reforestation grew out of forestry and forest management methods that humans have practiced for hundreds of years, maybe even longer. From a forestry perspective, reforestation usually means planting a single species of tree to supply the commercial harvest of timber, pulp, or other forest products. However, planting a monocrop of trees does not bring back the forest ecosystem that previously stood in an area. When that's the goal, the activity is commonly called forest restoration, and it usually involves planting a suite of native species. There's a lot of overlap in how people talk about reforestation and forest restoration today because tree planting initiatives are often aimed at restoring vital ecosystem services that healthy forests provide. It should be noted that neither term should be confused with afforestation, which is establishing forests where they never stood before, such as on grasslands or deserts. Tree planting initiatives are more abundant than ever as the world attempts to deal with the multiple environmental crises we're facing, including climate change, biodiversity loss, and water scarcity. Healthy forest ecosystems provide many services that can help mitigate these problems. Forests' ability to store carbon is the chief driver of prominent tree planting projects like the Trillion Tree Campaign. But people also design reforestation initiatives to regulate water cycles, halt desertification, provide habitat for wildlife, and other outcomes that sometimes have to be balanced against one another. Reforestation projects need careful planning to ensure that the right trees are being planted in the right place. Some trees require so much water that they have actually caused water scarcity when planted in regions that couldn't support them. Tree planting initiatives have also been known to displace indigenous and local communities. Degraded farmland is a prime target for reforestation, but even these areas must be carefully chosen to ensure that agricultural production won't simply be moved elsewhere, and more forests cleared to make way for it. So crucial do scientists consider restoring forests and other ecosystems to ensuring a sustainable future for humanity that the UN declared 2021 to 2030 the decade on ecosystem restoration. Major international agreements promote ecosystem restoration as well. For instance, under the Bond Challenge, countries aim to restore 350 million hectares or 865 million acres of land by 2030. A recent study found that just under 15% of the tree cover the world lost over the past two decades has been offset by reforestation efforts and natural regeneration. That means there's a lot of planting left to be done, so let's make sure we get it right.